journey now. I gotta make it to Raven somehow. Though the devil tempts me, tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I've won and your worldly fame. If I could still, I wouldn't take another form of journey now. No, no,
started out traveling for the Lord many years ago. I've had a lot of heartaches, had a lot of grief and woe.
When I would stumble, then I would humble down, yeah. And it's there I'd say I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I gotta make it to heaven somehow. Oh, the devil tempts me, tries to turn me around. Offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I've won and worldly fame. If I could steal, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Buys mighty touch from above. Oh, and my soul needs healing. I begin to feel in His power. Yes, then I'd say I wouldn't take nothing for my journey. No, no, no. I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I've got to make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempts me, tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I've won and worldly fame. If I could steal, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. If I could steal, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
God bless and welcome into the Gospel Music Jukebox. Hey, I'm your host, Evangelist Brother Eddie Chaney, saying we love you, but as always, remember that God loves you most. Amen. All right, guys, we're looking forward to an exciting time tonight right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Internet company, been working on our internet deal here and stuff, so hopefully it'll hold up and be a little better quality. Maybe it won't be skipping in and out as bad. We'll find out as time goes on, right? Yeah, I know we will. All right, guys, we're going to run over and check our testimony line right here. So be blessed, and we'll be right back.
Hello, Brother Eddie. We love you, and we're praying for you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho, and the signal is not going to be very good on this. I'm using this touch screen phone that we picked up, and unfortunately, up in this mountain town here, the signal's not too good on it, so my voice is going to be distorted a little bit. But my mom, Jerry's cell phone's older, and it seems to work better, but she's not here today, and we ran it from 800 minutes down to 70 minutes making calls on there, so we got to get another call in, and hopefully we're going to get some more minutes put in on there today. So our house phone is still out. We got to take care of getting that sometime, too. And anyhow, I can use some prayers, prayer requests. I a piece of wood hit my foot, and it's all been black and blue and bruised. I've been having a hard time walking and sleeping, and I can use some prayers. I'm actually going to take a nap for a little bit right now. But anyhow, I need some prayers for my foot to be healed, and I thank Jesus that He is the healer. The devil's been trying to attack us here because we've been preaching. working against sin and helping those orphan kids, helping needy people, and we've been trying to be doers of the word from James 1:22 and not hearers only. And the devil gets mad at us at times here, and he attacks us. But I guess, like Brother Eddie says, it's a good thing, because if the devil's not attacking you, then, you know, you may not be living as radically for Jesus as what you should be living. So, I know that Jesus is a healer. It promises in Matthew 8:17 that Jesus took our infirmities. My foot by the stripes wounds, and in the name of Jesus Christ, and I'm just for anyone that needs healing, please turn your life over to Jesus. Accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, and he will heal you. I've been healed from a serious back injury from a car accident. I thought I was going to have multiple surgeries, and my back was healed. I'd never have surgery on it, and I thank Jesus he healed me then. I know he's healing my foot. I've seen people healed like that of cancer and diseases when they turn their life over to Jesus. And I've seen people healed of so many sins and problems. I used to have pornography problems, all kinds of problems of anger and cursing and stuff like that. When Jesus came into my heart and life, he saved, changed me and got those sins out. We've been working with people in prisons who've had severe drug addictions, different problems, and I've seen Jesus, them accept Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior and get set free from those sins. So Jesus will love you and he'll set you free from those sins if you're having problems, and he'll heal you of sicknesses and diseases. Please turn your life over to Jesus. And we love you all. We're praying for you, and God bless you, and have a good day. Amen.
Living in the light of a risen Savior, living in the light of a kingdom come, living in the light of his grace and favor, living in the night with the hope of dawn, living my life to tell his story, living to tell what he's done for us, living my life in the light of glory, living in the light of love. Living in the light of his kingdom come, living in the light of his grace and favor, living in the night with the hope of dawn, living my life to tell his story, living to tell what he's done for us, living my life in the light of glory, living in the light of love.
Glory, 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 living in the light of love. this is Brother Grunt from my house first down here in Johnson, Kentucky. I just want to give my testimony. I'm thanking God for another beautiful day that he provided for us, another day to be able to get out and witness and serve a mighty king that he blessed me this morning to get up and just take another breath to be able to preach his gospel and do his will. And if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, it's time that you come to the facts and understanding and believe that the Lord Jesus Christ has come this very moment, this very second, that you can also be healed by his great power and his mercy. But most of all, that if you believe in him, he shall save your soul. Because one great day he's coming back, and that time is coming soon. So brothers and sisters, from me to you and from the house of prayer and from the heavenly hands of Jesus Christ, he's calling you. Love all of you. God bless.
The doctor says the cancer's back. The treatment should have done the trick. Can't help but wonder why I'm still sick. Been serving God for many years. Through the pain and through the tears. People wonder how I deal with it. My faith was built for times like this. My faith is built, Jesus strong, by every sermon and every song. Bible tough and fortified to protect against Satan's lies. When it seems hope is gone and the valley goes on and on, I know the victory will soon be won. My faith is built, Jesus strong.
Hope is gone, and the valley.
Idaho, and we love you all, and we're praying for you, and I just called in a little bit ago with my testimony, and I called in again and preached a little, and then I was going to call in again and say a prayer. I can use prayers for myself. My heavy piece of wood hit my foot, and it's all black and blue and swollen and bruised, and it's been hard to walk, and I was up most of the night, so I'm going to take a nap for a little while right now. I'm not sure what time I'll be online later. But I just wanted to say a prayer for us all right now. Father, I love you with all my heart, mind, and soul. I want to come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins, for shedding his blood so that our sins can be forgiven, so that we can go to heaven. Please, Father, help us never to take that painful, horrible death that your Son, Jesus, had to go through when they nailed him to that cross and whipped the skin off of his back and drove the crown of thorns in with clubs and beat him and spit on him. Help us never to take that for granted. May we be changed so that we get the sin out of our life and truly repent. I want to pray for all those people that are struggling with the different sins like the pornography, and they dabble with and laugh about it and think it's funny, or the homosexuality and drug use and drunkenness and different sins. Help them to see how serious it is and help them to change and truly repent and get that sin out of their lives. You are the God who made the stars, the universe, the clouds, the earth, the water, the oceans, all that exists, and nothing is impossible with you. But in Isaiah 59:1-2, it says that sin separates us from you. You turn your face from us and won't hear us when we have sin in our lives. So help us to get the sin out. You are an incredible God, Father. Nothing is impossible with you. With the same power that you use to make those stars, that you know each by name, you can heal us and help us in our lives and whatever we need helped with. It says in Ephesians 3:20 that you do exceedingly abundantly above anything we ask, think, or imagine. It says in Luke 18:27, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. With your power, nothing is impossible to us, Father. All things are possible. Please heal us and help us. It says that Jesus took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses and carried our diseases on the cross. And I'm claiming right now that we are healed in the name of Jesus with your power. Let your healing power flow throughout our bodies and heal us. I'm claiming the total healing of my foot. I'm claiming the total healing of anyone hearing this that needs healed. We are healed. I'm claiming they are set free from their sins. They will be set free from those sins, and they will not be controlled by those sins. And please deliver anyone that's facing trials, challenges, and hardships in their lives. Deliver them and help them, and help them to feel your love and the love of Jesus. May many people turn their lives over to Jesus who haven't accepted Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. Father, please help them to turn their lives over to Jesus. And I love everyone so much. I pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless all. We love you.
Is with swift transition. Love, our birth unmoved can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold to his hand, to God's unchanging hand. Hold to his hand, to God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. When your journey is completed, have been true, fair and bright, your home in glory. Your enraptured soul will do.
this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. I love you all, and I'm praying for you all. And I just called in with my testimony. I'm going to call in again soon with a prayer. And I can use some prayers myself. A heavy piece of wood hit my foot, and it's all black and blue and swollen. And I'm going to take a nap right now for a little while. I'm not sure what time I'll be online because I was up most of the night last night. But the good thing news is that Jesus is the healer, and my foot is healed. In the name of Jesus, I praise and thank Jesus for healing my foot, for healing all of us who need healed. I just wanted to talk a little bit about the Bible and the scriptures. There's a lot of stuff in there. A lot of people, everyone believes in John 3:16. You believe in Jesus, and you're saved, and you go to heaven. But there's more to it than that also, because a lot of people say they believe in Jesus, but then they still dabble with the sins like the pornography and the homosexuality and the drunkenness and the drugs and don't have to get those sins out of their life. And we're really called to help needy people, orphan kids, widows from the James 1:27, any type of needy people. When we help them from the parable of the sheep and the goats, we're helping Jesus. And a lot of people believe the prosperity gospel and they don't want to help these needy orphan kids or widows or the kids on drugs and preach to them and help them and the homeless people and try to help them out and do their things like we should be doing. So what I really see in the Bible in John 13:34-35, Jesus says that the world will know his disciples by their love for each other. And if you're a true disciple of Jesus, if you, Jesus Christ is truly your personal Lord and Savior, his love and Holy Spirit will flow into your heart and life. It will totally change you like it did me. It will get the drug, it will get the pornography stuff in my, like was in my life out. It will get the drug use, the drunkenness, those sins out of your life. It will change you. And then you'll be out there just longing to do the will of God because you love Jesus. You'll love the other people and you'll be longing to help the orphan kids and the widows and the people in prisons and go to the hospital and pray for people and do the things like we're called to do, helping others in the parable of the sheep and the goats and going and preaching the gospel to all creation and telling people about Jesus and getting them saved and doing the will of God as we're called to do in Matthew chapter 7. If we truly are changed like this and get the sin out and go out there and do the will of God, we'll be welcomed into heaven. If we don't truly live like that, Jesus could look at us and call us workers of iniquity and say, depart from me, I never knew you. You can read that in Matthew chapter 7. Then he will say, I never knew you, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. So let's all truly be changed by Jesus and go out there and do the will of God and help other people and show the love of Jesus to the world so we can be welcomed into heaven. Amen. God bless you all. We love you.
Alive and well.
Somebody say amen. Somebody start ringing a bell.
Heaven knows there's a whole lot of trouble living down here below.
But we're smiling because when this whole life is over, we got someplace else to go.
Oh, oh. God's people are happy people.
Be a friend to the world. See how much love you can give.
Life is more than the air you're breathing, or spending more than you can afford.
But happy are the people who always remember that happiness is the Lord.
Yeah, yeah. God's people are happy people. Happy all of the time. Joy higher than the tallest steeple. Love of the unstoppable kind. More than 10 million reasons flooding through my soul and my mind. God's people are happy people. Happy people shine.
shine, shine. Happy people shine.
God's shine, people shine. Are happy people.
Happy people all the time.
God's shine, people shine. Are happy people. Happy all of the time.
God's 10 million
are happy people. Happy people shine. Happy all of the time. God's people are happy people. Happy people shine. God's people are happy people. Happy all of the time. God's people are happy people. Happy people
Amen. Praise God. God's people are happy people. Hey, good to see Brother Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer there in the chat room, along with Brother Bobby from Cookeville, Tennessee. Hey, God bless you guys. Love you. We're not doing the Sam Vandenberg storytelling tonight because he is down sick. Last night we didn't air. I done made arrangements to do something else on Wednesday nights, and Wednesday nights will be Pastor Eddie Garrett and Evangelist Christopher Chaney from Saving America One Soul at a Time. So Wednesday nights, I'm not going to be here, guys. But they were sick, both of them, and they couldn't make it last night. So we're looking forward to next Wednesday. Maybe they'll be, well, we claim victory. They're going to be healed and up and about, and busy for the kingdom of God. Amen. Hope all is well with you there in the chat room. We're not going to be doing a full program tonight. I was definitely unprepared, but we're going to try to be working on upgrading this room and getting things ready for tomorrow night. So we're probably going to go about another 15 minutes, and then we'll call it a night. So thank you for stopping by and checking us out, and pray for us. I just walked through the door, just got off work, came from work, and fired up the program. So I went through one door and out the other door at the house. Praise God. So it's been a long, good, godly day. Amen. God's good. All right, guys. Give this a listen, and we'll be right back.
Hello, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We love you all, and we're praying for you. And I was going to call in with my testimony and call again with a prayer. And my testimony is that Jesus is my personal Lord and Savior, and He's my healer also. And I could use some prayers. I had a heavy piece of wood hit my foot, and my foot's all black and blue and swollen. I was up most of the night last night. I'm going to take a nap right now, so I'm not sure what time I'll be online later. I'll be online as soon as I can later. But anyhow, you know, Jesus is a healer. He heals people from sin. He says, you should know the truth, and the truth will set you free. He heals people from sicknesses and diseases. And my life, I used to be into pornography, lust, anger, cursing, foul language, had all kinds of just sins in my life that controlled me. When Jesus came into my heart and life as my personal Lord and Savior, well, He changed me, and I went out and baptized in water also, and He's had me, instead of doing those horrible sins, He changed me, where instead of doing that, I'm out helping the orphan kids almost every week or every week or two. We've been helping orphan kids out and fatherless kids, and He's had me helping some people that have been in the prison system with severe drug problems and doing different things like that, and helping many brothers and sisters around the world in different ways. And He just keeps me busy constantly for the kingdom of God, doing different things to help people. And instead of being caught up in those horrible sins, now I'm out there doing the will of God and showing the love of Jesus to the world, as we're called to do in John 13, 34 through 35, helping other people instead. And I don't ever want to go back to living that horrible, sinful lifestyle that I lived before I knew Jesus. And Jesus also was a healer. He promised us in Matthew 8, 17, he took our infirmities and carried our diseases. Prior to that, in that passage, he went out and healed all who were sick and cast the demons out of people. Isaiah 53, 4 through 5 says that we are healed by the stripes, wounds in the name of Jesus Christ. Psalm 103 says that God forgives all our iniquities, heals all of our diseases, and redeems our life from destruction. So my foot will be healed. I'm claiming healed, total healing of my foot. In the name of Jesus, I am healed, and we are all healed. I've been healed from a serious back injury before, and I've seen many people healed. Jesus gets the sin out of people's lives and heals them. He's healed me and got the sin out of my life, and that is my testimony. I love Jesus with all my heart, mind, and soul. He's my personal Lord and Savior. He got that horrible sin out of my life, and he's healed me and helped me so many times. God is good, and Jesus is good. Please accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. If you don't have Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, and he will heal you and help you. God bless you all. I love you. Amen.
Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. 'Cause it's good enough for me. It was good for my brothers and sisters. It was good for my brothers and sisters. It was good for my brothers and sisters.
Fight this battle, Lord. Show worth fighting for. I pledge my undying love to you. You died for me, though I live such a shameful life. Your grace has set me free, so I'm honored to struggle, Lord. In my toughest battles, you're worth fighting for.
Hello, friends. This is Chaplain Gary Rayburn of Les Wilson Incorporated Receiving in God Ministries. We want to thank you for listening, and our prayer is that you'll receive a blessing from this message we have for you today. Together with Bob and Stephanie Wilson, we have started a bold and brand new ministry, not only for Carmi in Southern Illinois, but we are reaching out all across the country. Planning on taking this ministry all over the world. Receiving in God Ministries is located at 215 Industrial Avenue, and we're currently having a daily service Monday through Friday at 12:30 p.m. We call our upper room service, and we invite everyone to come join us and see what's going on here at Carmi. It's a time of prayer, devotion, Bible study, and testimony. So sit back, listen, and enjoy this message, and then we encourage you to stop by and visit us at Receiving in God Ministries and pick up our free CD of this message and many more messages to share with your family.
You died for me, though I live such a shameful life. Your grace has set me free, so I'm honored to struggle.
All right, friends, I'd like to get this CD started off with a song I wrote called How Great Are His Signs. I wrote this one day driving up northern Illinois. The Lord just kind of spoke to me, and I reached over and grabbed my Bible, and I opened it up to Daniel chapter 4, and these words just jumped off the page at me. How great are his signs, how mighty are his wonders. And I just started writing this song, and then I got my good friend Carlin Loker to help me finish this song, and he put the music to it, and I'd like to play it for you. It's called How Great Are His Signs.
His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. How great are his signs, his mighty voice thunders. How great are his signs, how mighty are his wonders. How great are his signs, he shows in me. I stand here in awe, I lift up my eyes. Lord, I hear your voice, my whole heart cries. Your Holy Spirit power flows into me. Your signs and wonders, I pray all will see. His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. How great are his signs, his mighty voice thunders. How great are his signs, how mighty are his wonders. How great are his signs, he shows in me. From on my knees, hands lifted high, I surrender, Lord, I surrender my life. I give you my heart, you pay for my soul. I feel your presence, Jesus, make me whole. His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. His voice is so powerful, majesty. How great are his signs, his mighty voice thunders. How great are his signs, how mighty are his wonders. How great are his signs, he's shown to me. Through all my strife, you gave to me the sign of my life. By grace am I saved, by your stripes I am healed. By your Holy Spirit promise, I have been sealed. His voice is so powerful, of majesty. His voice is so powerful, so full of majesty. How great are his signs, his mighty voice thunders. How great are his signs, how mighty are his wonders. How great are his signs, he's shown to above and gave me the sign of my life. That's the sign of love.